Hello and welcome to this tutorial. Today, I'm going to show you how to create a time lapse using the webcam on your laptop or PC. So, to get started, first you have to download this software. I have included a link to it in the description, so click on that and it will take you here. This software comes in two versions. There's a free version and a paid version. Obviously, the paid one has a bit more features, but even as a free version, this is a great software. It has many useful features to create a great looking time lapse. So download and install it and also support its developers as well. When you are going to launch the software after installing it, it will initially ask you to choose a project type. And it will give you a number of options like create stop motion video or animation or broadcast it live. But as we are making a time lapse using our webcam, so we are going to choose the first option. Then it will ask you to select a recording device. As you can see, the webcam is already selected, so click next. Next, it is asking you to select a record interval. Basically, this is after how many seconds or minutes do you want your webcam to capture an image. So we will discuss about it and change its value later in the video. So as for now, simply click next. Lastly, it will ask you to type a project name. So type any name you want and click next. We are ready to go now, so click finish. There are a number of things to go through in this software. The first one is the video preview. I have intentionally hidden it due to privacy reason, but if you have a webcam installed on your PC or laptop, you should see its video preview here. The next thing is that there are a number of options available at the right side of the screen to help you record a time lapse. We will quickly discuss each one of them. Here the first option is about the project. We have already selected a project type and we have also assigned a name to our project. Here it is asking you about your location, so you can add your latitude and longitude here. This is required if you want to broadcast your time lapse live. As we are not doing that in this video, so we will not modify these values. The next option is about your capturing device. So if we expand this, the first thing you can do is change your resolution. These are the only resolution available for my webcam, so I am going to choose this one. And then there's the device frame rate as well, which is also automatically detected. Here you can change your capturing device as well. So right now I'm using a USB camera, but I can change it. So if you have more than one camera installed, you will see it here and you can choose the one that you want. There is also an option for device properties as well. So if you click on it, and it will give you a number of properties that you can change. For example, you can change the brightness, contrast, saturation, etc. And if you change any one of them, you will see it in the video preview. So you will get a better idea of what you are changing. That is pretty much it in this section. We will leave the stream type and input unchanged. There is a button for more as well, and it will give you a bit more options. Here you can set the rotation of your input image, and you can also set the device warm-up time. For example, if your device requires a few seconds before it can start capturing, so you can set that here. For this video, we will leave the settings unchanged. The next option is the output speed, and this is very interesting. So here you can choose the speed mode, which is currently set to time interval, and there are a number of different options as well, but we will leave it to the time interval because we want to capture our image after a certain amount of time. The next option is the image capture, so it will ask you after how many seconds or minutes the webcam should capture an image. So you can set it to basically anything. For example, if I set it to every 30 seconds, this means that the resulting time lapse will be 909.09 times faster. This also means that an hour of capturing will be equal to a 4 seconds video, and a day of capturing will be equal to a 1 minute and 35 seconds video. So you can set it according to the time lapse that you are making. For example, if you are recording over several days, then you should keep this number high. And if your recording is not that large, then you should keep this number low. You can also use a custom interval as well. So now you can provide your value in milliseconds. For example, if I write 792 here, this means that a day of capturing, that is 24 hours of capturing, will be equal to an hour long video. And an hour of capturing will be equal to a 2 minutes and 30 seconds video. So you can choose this according to the time lapse that you are making. The rest of the options should remain unchanged. For example, we want the frame playback duration to match the video file frame rate. There is also an option for more in this section as well. Here it is asking you to select the frame rate of the resulting video file. My suggestion is to keep it at 30. So now we are done with this section as well. The next setting is about size and crop. And as the name shows, if you want to crop out an area from your time lapse, you can do so from here. Similarly, there is also a section about filters. Here you can choose which filter you want to apply to the time lapse. You can either auto enhance it or you can change each one of them manually. You can check the show filters in preview option to view these filters in the video preview. Then there's the output file and encoder section. So basically here you can set the location of the output file, the time format, and the image quality as well. Here you can also set a time after which it should create a new file. This is done for safety purposes. Basically, if you don't want a single video file of your time lapse and you want your time lapse to be divided over a number of video files, you can set a time here after which it will create a new file while recording the same time lapse. So we are done with the output file and encoder section. So let's briefly discuss the broadcast live section. Basically, this setting allows you to stream your time lapse live over a video platform. And since we are not doing that in this video, so we will ignore it. The next option is about timestamp. Here you can print a title on your video and you can also print the date and time. If you check both show overlay in preview and show timestamp on video, it will then show your title and the date and time on the video preview. As with the other settings, you can choose it according to your requirements. It also has an option for motion detection. So it will detect a motion event and it will start capturing if that event is true. So this is a cool feature that you can use. However, in this video, since we are going over the basics, we are not going to use this. You can also set a schedule for your time lapse. So if you want the software to start recording at a certain day, then you can set that here. Then we have the option for reliability. Here you can set some actions for the computer to execute in an event of a failure. So it can be set to restart the window or the input device, or you can also run a custom script on it. However, after using this application for a long time, I can tell you that it is very stable. The software has recorded videos for up to 16 hours without any problem. And now we are done with these sections. Once you have chosen your desired settings, you can simply click on the start button to start recording. This will be indicated by the red bar here. And also this recording light will start blinking as well. If the application is recording, it will show you the time here. So it will show you the time from the start of the recording and the time duration of the resulting video. And once you want to stop the recording, you can simply click on the stop button. So it will show you the output file here along with its size that you can view. So that is all for this video. Please let me know in the comments below if you have any confusion regarding each of the settings that we have discussed. Also, please leave a like and subscribe to my channel for more straightforward tutorials like this one. Thank you for watching.